Okay, let's have a look at what's going on in South Africa. Full disclaimer, I know it's a serious situation. I hope everyone is okay. I'm not going to give heated opinions about it like I live there. I only act like I fully understand a place I don't live in when it comes to America, not South Africa or anywhere else. Let's look at this moment for what it is. We have a bloke that wants a free big fuck off TV. He's chosen a 58-inch. I believe it has Netflix already on there, which is handy. No one likes to invest in or loot a separate piece of technology to access a streaming service. He's in a pickle though. A 44-inch TV would have suited his car a lot better. I'll let the original commentary from the news reporter tell us what's happening next.
He's trying to open the boot now. Let's see what his plan is. It's all the boot is already full.
Yeah, look at all the bloody goodie bags already in there. I gotta say, I love that he has his hazard lights on. This is a person that respects the rules of the road. Sure, he's in the middle of a theft, but he's a considerate driver. So that fucking counts for something. I reckon this sticker on the back window is a spoiler as to where he's going next. Lock down the Apple store, Timbo. Lock it down, mate. It feels like half of his car is full of panic shopping because of the pandemic, and the other half is due to political unrest stuff. What a complex time to be alive. Anyway, is there too much junk in the trunk, or will the telly make it in? It's looking kind of secure. Not really. Is there a super cheap auto nearby? Just go loot some ratchet straps. Oh, look at these arrogant wankers rubbing it in his face with their TV on the roof, working as a team. That's insensitive. To show off in front of a lone looter like that? Fuck them. I keep forgetting that he's stealing it, to be honest. I have a deep innate feeling to go give him a hand. It's the kind of bloke I am. I see struggle, I wish to help. Oi, actually, what if he's not stealing it? What if he's the only person in South Africa buying a new TV during this dodgy week? The retail clerk was like, sorry, I can't open the loading bay because looters will get in. I can't help you carry it because that will breach COVID restrictions. Good luck out there. Try not to void the warranty. Super fair dinkum awkward if that is the case. Oh no, there's traffic blocking us. Sort it out, ENCA news team. Oh, they are. They're going in. That's professional. The bloody reporter is going in for a chat. I think he said, go put the telly back, you goose. But yeah, nah, he loves it. This particular fella is enjoying the apocalyptic environment. As I said, it's a complex time to be alive. Has his car decided to shit itself? I think it has. This is the slowest getaway ever from the world's worst looter ever. One speed bump, and that TV is history. Our noble man on the ground is like, there you have it. I've worked 36 minutes overtime, so I'm heading home to have a mid-strength beer and a Panadol. That's the fucking news today. Back to you in the studio, Sandra.